This plant is a banana tree. So some of you also know I like bananas, and I are going to try to let this one become so big that I can harvest bananas from it. If you like that, to see the process of me growing this little plant, comment it, and maybe I will show you the process. And if you have some tips about how I can let this one grow faster, put them in the comments. I was thinking about doing something new, but also something old school. Because you may know, if you are following me for years and years, that I have done in the past sometimes something like an quote Friday, when I have done any Friday to quote some inspirational or quotes that make you think about some stuff. Maybe some are depressing, some are fun. And I was thinking, maybe I will bring it back. Now, let me start. The first one is, so far I say indeed, is from author, whoever, I don't know the name. And the quote is actually this. The victim is nothing to defend, not more than the next victim. The victims are interchangeable. This author says actually that all forms of oppression have their basic essence in arbitrary systems of systematic oppression, which means that if you look on how oppressors often talk, they say things like to the victims, prove to me why I should be kind to you. You don't look like me. Act like me, and then I will maybe respect you. Always like that. They mock their entire existence of their victims, and so I say before, use arbitrary criteria to oppress others. Whites in Americans have done that with blacks, and Arabs have done that with whites and Indians. How they are called pagans or idol worshippers of infidels. And if you don't believe me, you can check out my article I've posted time ago on my Facebook, I think it was. I will put it in the description below so you can check it out. Let me go to the next one. All through past the three stages. First, it is mocked and ridiculed. Secondly, it is violently opposed. And then, it is accepted as self-evident. This is a quote from Arthur Schopenhauer. I think it falls from studies in pessimism, or the world in its representation, that can also be. But I think studies in pessimism. But I'm not sure. This is a thing you see over the time, all right, always. First, people mock the ones who speak up for the victims, ridicule them, make fun of them. They say, oh, you care about blacks? fine for you, but I am going to laugh about you if you want to speak up for them. That's what slavers say. Or, and then the abolitionists starting to free slaves from the plantations and learn them to read. And then the slave masters become angry and say that the conditions on the slave plantations weren't so wrong. And that they treat their property well. Like James Hammond liked to point out. The student slave owner. And governor of Carolina. And the same thing people we see with the veganism. People, when I was starting to go vegan 14 years ago, keep in mind the country where I live is around 10 years after America. Things that are happening now are starting to be seen in America 10 years ago. For example, with veganism and that kind of things. So I did have the same kind of knowledge that I can find on the internet when I was starting, as people how are now 40 years vegan. If I was knowing the things I did now today, I 100% sure started to go vegan when I was a toddler, I think. If somebody explained it to me in a very relaxing way, I am sure I started go vegan when I was a toddler. I did not like animal cruelty, and I think you also not. I hope so, at least. But you are defending things because business as usual, or I appeal to finity. Appeal to the status quo, social contracts, whatever other logical fallacy. I, by the way, in lists of logical fallacies, and I explained them in this video in there. Check the link out. Then, violently opposing and lying about the activists. It was in the time of slavery no different than in the time of today with animal rights. Slavery, slave masters, and people who did support slave trade, which are basically the majority of white men, since now, I think this quote of Elie Wiesel, concentration camp survivor, will summarize this the best. Take sides. Neutrality helps the oppressor. Nothing the oppressed. Silence encourages the tormentor. Nothing the torment it. You don't need to have a lot of people who act out of pure malice to create a psychotic system. How seems like malice. You only have to have a large group of people who are acting mostly out of selfishness. People who want to blame somebody because they are don't want to take their own responsibility for their actions, like Hitler have done in the Third Reich. With the blaming of Jews and Gypsies for the problems the Germans themselves have created. And if you are German, don't feel offended by that, because I consider that the full truth, and if you want to debate me on that, I'm ready for that, mate. The farmers say they are attacked by vegans. Slave masters say that slave abolitionists are violating their rights and stealing their property. Animal rights activists are accused of stealing the property of modern day plantation owners, how call themselves farmers, and how I call breeders. At this time that we learned that other living beings are not property, and that we considering animals as property is a violation of their rights as living sentient creatures, like the Cambridge Declaration of Consciousness implies. All animals to be. Specifically, many kinds of birds and mammals and cetaceans, like the vitreta and the boar whale and the sperm whale, how I actually should be called the leviathan and the pygid whale, how some of you know as the mink whale, if you want to know why I don't use that word, you can check out you can check out why Paul Watson that does not call the mink whale the mink whale. It is basically because it is the name of one whaler, and it is an insult to a species to actually give him the name of a sociopath who hunts whales. And the sperm whale is the name also not coming from the whalers, and that refers to the sperm shaking oil that is in the trunk of the whale, and that was used for industrialized machinery oil because it is highly heat resistant and was used for nuclear weapons. So I was thinking, what the hell? People killed, actually, by far one of the most special, most important species on the planet for the manufacturing of nuclear weapons. What the? I'm totally have no words for it. I have no words for it. I think our species is psychotic. Destroying the biosphere of the ocean for a taste pleasure of fish for a couple of seconds. Check out my video about the destruction of the ocean. The last stage of acceptance is when people are stopping making excuses and start to pay attention to the problems on this world and not blaming anymore the liberationists, the activists, the abolitionists, but are going to start reflecting on themselves, evolve, apologize for the way they are living, make a please and move forwards. Are you ready to face yourself? Like a responsible person? Instead of a spoiled little breath? Stop feeling like a victim. You're not a victim. If you can watch this video, if you have internet, if you live in the first world, if you have a car, if you have food and water, you are not a victim.